dinosaurs. They are still alive. I think they're still among us. But how can dinosaurs still be alive when they were killed by an asteroid 66 million years ago? Well, it turns out it's actually not that simple. While school books are quite happy with the story of an asteroid that killed all the dinosaurs, scientists are not. There's still quite a debate going on what actually killed the dinosaurs. The asteroid impact in Mexico did take place for sure. Scientists were able to find the impact crater, it's called the Chicxulub crater, and we also find little pieces of molten rock and metals all across the world that can be linked to this impact event. Also, asteroids carry a lot of iridium, which is normally not found on the Earth in high abundances, and a spike of iridium concentration could be linked with the disappearing of dinosaur fossils in the ground. This peak marks the end of the dinosaurs and the beginning of a new geological area, the Tertiary. The extinction event is also called often the KT extinction event. This could be the end of our story. The asteroid hits the Earth and kills off all the dinosaurs. Subscribe! But wait, not so quick. Some scientists are actually saying that the Chicxulub impact of the meteorite happened 300,000 years before the dinosaurs went extinct. This would mean that there is another cause for the dinosaur extinction. Other phenomena like increase in temperature, like global warming, or increased volcanic activity have been proposed to affect the dinosaurs. The debate which of those factors really caused the dinosaur extinction is quite heated, but a publication just a few weeks ago actually showed that the Chicxulub impact and the KT boundary are actually very close together on a time scale. So with improved measurements of the age in drilling cores, scientists could link both events and show that they fall in the same time. Therefore, it was concluded that the Chicxulub impact did indeed kill the dinosaurs. However, the scientists also stressed that the dinosaurs were already badly affected by things like climate change or volcanic activity when the meteorite hit them. I think it's quite funny to observe that some scientists are really into their theories, so they say it really has to be the meteorite or whatnot, and they seem to forget sometimes that probably all of those effects combined did actually kill the dinosaurs. I, as a biologist, worry less about the individual events, but more about the environmental changes that each event triggered. To understand the extinction of the dinosaurs, we need to find out why the dinosaurs were not able to adapt to the strong environmental changes. Because some mammals and also a lot of other groups did in fact survive the impact event and the harsh conditions. So let's think about what the conditions on the planet could look like after the asteroid impact. The asteroid for sure will have disturbed a lot of matter that is going into the air. So the whole Earth was basically covered by a lot of dust, so very few light could actually go onto the Earth. This probably led to a lot of plants to die off, and very simple plants like ferns took over. With less sunlight from the sun, there would be less energy, less food for other organisms. So this could be a big problem for very big dinosaurs because they might not be able to find enough food. However, we also have some small dinosaurs, so why didn't they survive? Well, this could maybe be explained by a drop in global temperature, because most dinosaurs are believed to be cold-blooded, and therefore they would be more susceptible to pathogens like fungi or viruses. Mammals, on the other hand, which are warm-blooded, we all maintain our body temperature, might have been able to cope much better with pathogens, because they could increase the temperature. We are still doing this sometimes today. When we are sick, we develop a fever. So we increase our body temperature to kill off the pathogens. However, this cannot be the only reason why mammals were so successful, because also some reptiles, who are cold-blooded like most dinosaurs, could survive the harsh conditions. So there have to be some additional factors that prevented the dinosaurs from surviving. Maybe let me know in the comment section if you have some ideas. I did say that most dinosaurs are cold-blooded, however, there was one group that potentially was warm-blooded, and this group is in fact still around today. And those are the birds. While most people are saying that dinosaurs generally went extinct, this is not true. Some dinosaurs did survive and evolved into birds. So dinosaurs are still among us. In fact, you can take a look at the dinosaur fossil Archaeopteryx in Berlin, which is showing a key step from the evolution of dinosaurs to the birds we see flying around today. To make this clear again, dinosaurs are not extinct, we are just calling them birds today. While the evolution of dinosaurs to birds is widely accepted, scientists are still trying to find out the last details of the dinosaur extinction. Let's hope that scientists reach a consensus on the environmental triggers and look more towards the question why dinosaurs were not able to adapt to the environmental changes. So, with the big dinosaur war, I say thank you for watching and until next time, bye bye!